What is so we're filming Swapmoto live today at Callaway, and my buddy Scott Sipkovic, Hollywood, dropped off some Arma for the set.
Just had to take care of the guys.
Yeah, so I love this stuff. I know a lot of people that love this stuff. I'm not that intelligent, just saying, dude, it's good, take it. So give me the rundown, bro.
Well, the protein is 100% grass-fed whey, mm-hmm. which that's really important these days. And it's, you know, non-GMO. Our cows are eating really well in nice green pastures.
Yeah.
Also, it has curcumin, which is the active ingredient of turmeric, which is good for inflammation in your joints. Mm-hmm. Also has MCT oil, which MCT comes from the coconut, which is good for your cognitive health, good for your brain. Has good fats, good energy. Also, we have the Blitz, which, you know, Blitz is a great product. It's a great endurance product. We almost dropped it over there. So this is a really good one. It has your beta alanines, it has your BCAAs. It also has sustamine, D-ribose. Sustamine is, they claim to be the number one muscle hydration ingredient. Look it up, it's a good ingredient.
So Blitz is the thing you drink in between motos, before motos.
Before, in between, and after.
Mm-hmm.
It's a product that we've had a lot of great feedback from our athletes on, and seems to do the job.
Nice.
So we're really happy about that.
And Fire.
Then we have Fire, which
that's
is a
before ride. Before
yeah, so workout. That's a little, if you want a little boost in focus, it's a whole green coffee bean, and the way that the bean is ground, it's a trademark process, and it gives you a 4 to 6 hour clean, sustained boost in focus. And this one is very simple ingredients, only has 3 grams of sugar,
mm-hmm.
and WGCP, which is clinically tested by the Cleveland Clinic. And it's a great for, you know, when you're going to the starting line, you want a little boost and a little focus.
I actually quit drinking coffee for a while, and I would have a bottle of Fire in the morning.
Yeah, it's, you know, with the coffee is, the beans are roasted, and with the whole green coffee bean, the way that our bean is ground, it actually is like a little bit of pulp in your drink.
I like the crunchies.
Yeah, and that's actually the green bean, and it's the way that the body digests that that gives you the slow 4 to 6 hour clean, sustainable boost and focus.
Cool. All right, so you got McGrath, Way, and Reed involved, and I know a lot of athletes are using it. I saw like Christian Craig switched over, and that was pretty important because, you know, you guys are recognized by
Informed Sport. Yeah. Is, you know, we're certified. Every one of our products are certified by Informed Sport, so they're tested, which is USADA and WADA approved. Mm-hmm. Informed Sport, the certification. So as a professional athlete, it's really important that whatever you're putting in your body, you know, mm-hmm. what's in the product.
Yeah.
And every one of the batches are tested. It's important that any product that you look at as well, that if it's just the brand that has some products that are Informed Sport certified, that doesn't mean all of their products mm-hmm. are Informed Sport certified.
Yeah.
So you have to look for the symbol on the package, the Informed Sport certification logo, and that means that that product is actually tested and approved. And, you know, I just think it's really important as a professional athlete, that's where you earn your money. You got to make sure that you protect your assets, which is your earning potential.
Definitely. Well, it's been exciting to watch the brand take off, buddy. And
well, thank you guys.
I enjoy the product very much, and best of luck. So it's armasport.com.
Armasport.com.
Phew. Hey, tell me what's going on in this room.
Well, we're trying to raise money for Mickey Diamond. There's a wall full of pictures. We got hundreds of pictures from the 80s of all the guys back in the day. And a lot of pictures being sold already. So if you haven't done so, come down, rush down here and buy some fast.
Nice. I'm sure some of these are going to be in your book.
Most of these are going to be in the book. We're doing a book, The Golden Age of Motocross, coming out next year. A big, thick coffee table book. So look out for it. Go to the website, Golden Age of Motocross. Motocross, The Golden Era. And sign up, subscribe, and we'll send you emails and things. And we're giving away prints every month. So if you sign up, subscribe, Motocross, The Golden Era, go take a look.
I guess I'm testing the low light abilities of the new GoPro 8. It's 5:45 a.m. on Tuesday. Went to the Mickey Diamond fundraiser last night at Pole Position. It was pretty cool. Got to see like so many like motocross heroes and legends there. Anyway, it's early in the morning Tuesday. Gonna go meet my buddy Fernando to get a quick Skyline ride up before we start the day. So, gonna ride with the old trusty bike mount again. Try not to breathe so hard, because last video somebody said I need a respirator. And I'll be sure to put my sunglasses on over the straps, all right? So this is my buddy Fernando.
What's up, guys?
Fernando's a tattoo artist. He's the one who did my my daughter's names on my arms. And one day we're talking and I'm all, dude, you lost a bunch of weight. And he's all, I got a mountain bike. So he started on an e-bike. He's just got riding a conventional bike now, a Eminent. And he's crushing Skyline. The first time I took him down these trails, I think you were a little sketchy, huh?
Just a little bit, yeah.
Yeah. Shit, now I can't keep up with him. Hauling ass.
Just having fun.
Headed to Milestone today. Pretty excited to ride my 350 today. Excuse the fucked up garage. That with this bad boy stuff. So, big brother Ross, he takes Husky WP stuff and basically makes it into Yamaha forks with KYB internals inside. So I gave my gear bag away to my buddy Pablo Toribio to take all the stuff he bought on vacation back to Singapore with him. So I'm without a gear bag today. Sick gear bag. What's up, dude?
Oh yeah.
How'd the fit test go?
I'm not sure yet.
You didn't get the results?
Well, I got them, but try not to release them to the public. They're so good.
Well, so what did it entail? Because it took 2.5 hours?
No, the test itself was probably 25 minutes, something like that. But going over the details of what it meant was what took so long. I basically, because I'm an idiot, I had to sit there and talk for a while. But like, I now get it, and I need to train less gnarly at sometimes, and
then lower intensity, or
just as gnarly when I'm doing by other days. So it's like it's.
So they're writing you a program,
helping me do my helping me understand my own.
Yeah.
Which was cool. So I did it running because I always run. So I'm not a cyclist.
Yeah.
And I did it running, so the numbers are a little bit different. But now that I have that one running, I'm gonna go back here soon and get another one done and actually see like my progress.
My
ideas.
So you were in San Marcos, right? Because you weren't too far from where we were shooting our shows.
That's where we did the test with San Marcos. So
I've
been hanging out over there, riding those little Q-Bird bikes a lot too.
Really?
Been hanging out by there. Yeah.
Ah, nice.
It's just fun.
Well, we gotta get you on the show next time, man.
Yeah, I'm down for sure.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Franco.
Don't do it. I didn't know who you were going.
Can we talk about that?
Come on, talk.
How you got a fox tattoo and you ride like seven guy?
I know, seven. Huh? They keep saying they're going to pay to get it covered up. Roger does, but never comes up. I was like high school. That was my first tattoo. I mean,
Was it?
Me and a couple other buddies from my high school class just got those. I went one Sunday. I think we just turned 18 or something.
Yeah.
17 and were able to get it. I think I even had to get like a signature from my mom or someone to sign on.
Oh, really? Oh, shit.
Yeah, that was back
Okay, so back
the
then,
shit.
Yeah, Fox used to be the shit back then, right?
Yeah, it did.
Everybody was getting Fox tattoos.
Yeah, I mean, there's probably a lot out there, you know, but.
So you got a 7 tattoo yet?
Nah, not yet. I'm going to get the 7.
You're going to get the dot?
Up. Yeah.
You get the dot? Yeah.
I know more of that.
How's Moto like? Did you ride that thing yet?
Not yet. I was trying to get out last weekend, but it was Halloween weekend, so I went to a couple Halloween parties and woke up kind of not feeling like I wanted to ride, but I'm hoping we can go out probably as soon as we get back from Paris, for sure.
Right on.
Yeah.
All right. No high sides.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, this is sick. That's a cool detail right there.
It's gonna take a month to get that.
What are you doing about a bike in Paris? Are you taking just parts? Being provided
by? I'm gonna take a couple things, but we actually shipped a bike for the first time.
Oh, you did?
Me and Malcolm been doing it. I've been with Malcolm doing it for the past couple years. We've always taken parts, but yeah, this time we able to fly with the bike. We had a little incident happen last year too.
Yeah. Because wasn't that bike Friese's bike that was there?
Friese raced it the weekend before. It's a couple weeks before. And, it was supposed to be a stock brand new bike, but.
So what bike did you ship over? Is it a brand new bike specifically for Europe?
It was a bike that we rode out here. It was like a bike that we had in the summer riding outdoors.
Uh-huh.
So basically the same setting, just 19, not a 20.
Do you like going to Europe?
It's fun. This will be fun too, because it's probably a little bit less work having a bike shipped, and then we'll use that bike for Geneva also. So,
Do you have much luck with Tinder in Paris?
I didn't have a Tinder last year out there, but I got one now, so we'll see how it see how it works.
Hey, what does that even say?
What?
On your socks. Seared what?
Oh. Send nudes.
No, we're not.
But like,
we're not
right but now, like it's a play on noodles, you know? It's supposed to look like, cup of noodles. But it says send nudes. Have you ever sent a nude, Malcolm?
One, and it got screenshot. It's floating around somewhere, I'm assuming. But it's like, probably I was in high school. So, I ain't too worried about it.
But you get the nudes. The nudes come the other way, right?
Getting a nude don't really do nothing for me because it's like you see it, but all you gotta do is Google boobs or whatever on Instagram or Google, and you get the same thing. So
yeah, that's true. So, are you pumped about Paris in a couple days?
Oh yeah, I'm pumped just because it's a difference. I haven't been to the new stadium, so that'd be pretty fun for me. And then I heard it's not too far from whenever you land. I think it'd be pretty cool. Maybe, like I said, we get there a day early, so this time I'll probably go visit Eiffel Tower and all that stuff.
Oh, you didn't do that last time?
No, I have never been to it.
Dude, it's
sick. As many times I've been. Well, usually what we do is we land and we drive, you know, an hour or so to Lille.
Yeah.
And then, you know, that's kind of far, but I heard, like I said, the stadium is not too far away from the city or whatever.
Yeah, it's right in the middle. Man, where the stadium's at, the hotel's walking distance, so it's pretty cool.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So
you know, do you speak any French?
Oui, oui.
Wee wee.
That's all I got. Wee wee and was that bonjour? Something like
bonjour,
that.
Bonjour, yeah, that's hello.
Yeah, that's it. That's all I got. That's it. I feel like, you know, they understand what you're saying. Like if you speak English, they understand what you're saying. They just choose not to.
Yeah, they pretend they don't understand, right?
Yeah, they pretend that. Oh no. Yeah, you do. And you whip out some money. Oh, now you speak. now you speak my language. So.
Hey, I didn't see that headband in the 7 catalog. Yeah, is that custom?
It's a special limited edition for Malcolm only.
Malcolm only?
Yeah. Well, we're probably going to come out with some.
Yeah?
Yeah, we'll come out with something. It'd be like a little bit like it's a Mookie edition.
Mookie edition?
Only. It'll get sold out. It'll be sold out before it even hits the internet. Sold out.
Hey, is Burns going with you this weekend?
Mr. Burns?
Yeah.
Oh, he'll be there. I think he flies out tomorrow.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, we fly out tomorrow as well. So, looking forward to it. Not looking forward to that flight. Well,
yeah,
looking forward to going over there racing.
What do you do on the flight? What's your flight essentials in your backpack? What do you have to take?
Sometimes I just take like a
Take headphones, nah, right?
Yeah, headphones, but I usually take like these, I can't even think of it, like they're like pink. The
pink?
Little, the pill, the pink pill.
Oh, they make you go to sleep?
Yeah, wow. They're like Benadryl.
Benadryls, yeah, yeah, allergy pills.
Yeah, yeah, just out, puts me out. So, take one of those, Benadryl, and just go to sleep, really. Just try to, but I mean, you're sitting on a plane for 9-10 hours. I mean, you can only sleep that long. You're not even really that comfortable. But sometimes you get lucky on a plane, you get the whole middle row, so that's when you sleep good.
Yeah.
But usually we get it coming back, not always going there. Usually going there, it's always packed. So
yeah, you know, it's all pumped too.
Yeah, everybody's all excited.
We're gonna do it again. Rango, who looks better?
He's got to say the guy who pays him.
Mine's newer though.
Yeah. Newer no, what?
That's like a shoe.
You're years old. Shoe. They're like 3 years old, dude. Yeah. This is the new one. This is the new. It's a new Ethica collab, you know? It's the stretchy one.
Yeah, but you want to know something cool about this one? Nobody's got this one.
What are you talking about? I used to have that one. Yeah,
no.
Roger gave it to me.
You ain't got no more, huh?
You ain't got no more of
it. No, not no more.
You don't got no more of it, see? This limited edition right here.
It's not going to be a good day for you.
Why?
You're the second fastest brother today.
I see you down here all up on
me. Huh? I'm up there. I was over there trying to like tell him he got to hang out with his uncle Zoid today.
What'd he say?
He said, nah, that guy's not really black.
Hey, I'm gonna go have a word. I'm gonna give him a word of advice today. Oh yeah, like what could you make STD?
STD? You got an STD, Zoid?
Hey, tell him the story right now.
All right, so I was at Shop Road. I walked outside. And there's a black dude standing by my truck and he started screaming at me for that sticker.
No way! For Scrub Daddy training? Yeah.
He started calling him Cracker and everything.
Peckerwood.
No way. Dude. Oh shit.
Hey, and I could see if you'd have on the bottom, niggas love chicken. Then I could see him getting mad. But hey, the Colonel is getting funk like that?
This is the wrong way to be doing shit.
Like, huh? That's how we do it at Roy's.
No, dude, don't do that. Don't do that.
Little upgrade for the cheer bike. Maybe I keep up with Mathis now.
No, I want this one. This is the helmet I want.
Yeah. What do you think?
It's pretty cool. I mean, that's pretty cool. We can do that.
What kind of riding do you do?
You know, I just
it looks like a freestyle front wheel.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not really into, I mean, I went up to Snow Summit.
Uh-huh. Super fun.
I didn't go out on any trails.
No?
No.
Oh, dude, it's super fun up there.
Yeah, but if I do, I'm gonna need to get a bike like that.
Yeah.
I mean, except with the rural suspension.
Yeah. Dude, show me your bike. Give me a rundown.
Yeah, it's basically it's like a 90s KHS.
Uh-huh.
Friend of mine.
What are the hand? Oh, those are bar ends, huh?
Yeah. Well, actually, I think they're little kids handlebars.
No, these are bar ends. My friend.
Are they?
Jason McCune, he runs bar ends all the time.
Yeah, they're basically the Eaton.
Easton.
Yeah, EATON. They make softball bats.
Through there. That's my that's our company.
Oh, cool.
Just put it on your bike, dude. That'd be sick.
Yeah, I like it. I mean, I like it.
What are you doing, bud? Are you preparing shoes for Marvin Muscan? Roy Cyclery services half the motocross industry.
Bringing back a dirty bike.
What? You're bringing back dirty bikes to me, dude?
I know.
Are you serious?
I hate it. We had to bring back the dirty bikes. We're going to have to buy him dinner or something. So I owe you either Wood Ranch or that Sushi's Inn.
Oh,
I owe you a nice dinner.
Ronnie gave me back a dirty bike. Dude, and so did Pablo.
Pablo, he didn't really even care. But my dad, he was tore up about it. I didn't have time to wash it.
Dude.
Pops was tore up.
Pablo gave me back dirty bike.
Yeah.
Dude.
And I live in an apartment complex. Okay, I usually come over here to wash my bikes anyways.
Fucking work. I mean, it worked.
Ronnie.
I thought they were the wrong ones.
Ronnie. Pablo.
Your bike's still dirty from the weekend too.
Yeah, so.
How about this? Whenever I get back from Europe, I'll come over here and I'll detail these things. Because you know how good I am at washing a bike.
You'll wash it and it'll get stolen.
Yeah, dude, that's why I didn't wash them. Because I knew I was going to have to bring
them
back to
you. Bad things happen
when I've washed my bike. So how did
old Ron Dog like the bike?
He loved it. He said it had a lot of pepper. He liked it. Yeah.
Did he like the Talking Boy engine mounts?
Yeah, he liked them.
You could tell.
Yeah, it was just the suspenders were a little bit stiff for him. And then...
Wait. Did you put my clickers back?
No, I didn't.
Do you remember what you did?
Yeah, I think so.
What'd you do?
I went out like...
Five.
I went out five on the forks, out three on the shock, and out four on the rebound.
What about the fork rebound?
Didn't touch fork rebound.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, so... Yeah, the dang FMFs, they didn't have the baffle in them.
Oh, so
they were rigging his big old ears, you know? And then, you know, he's not the tallest of dudes, but he likes the ape hanger bars because he grew up riding Elsinore's for some reason.
These aren't ape hangers, these are RC bars. They're low.
I know, but he likes...
Oh, he likes them high.
He loves them high, dude. He rides like this.
Okay.
And, yeah, so, I mean, other than that, loved the thing. Loved it. Pablo, he's a little bit more picky, though. Pablo,
yeah, he had to buy work suspension and an
had
ECU.
Had to buy work suspension, ECU, had to buy bars, everything. Mm. Like, dude, he had a full-on factory bike this weekend. And then he stole the...
He stole my airbox cover, dude. What? Pablo.
He was actually going to replace it, but he said, I'll give it to you. He never gave it to me, so I don't know what happened there.
Pablo, dude. There's the shoes Pablo got you. Look at those things.
Dude, they're...
You're going to need green ones now.
Oh.
Oh. Hints. Hey, do you know where Muskin lives? I got some shoes for him from Roy's. Can you take them, though?
No, I don't know where he lives.
He's up the street.
He's competition, dude. He's competition.
No favors for that.
He's competition.
I got a text from Wilhan this morning early that the Star Yamaha team is going to be doing some testing and riding at Milestone. So I figured I'd haul ass out and get some content, see what they're up to. See how Shane McElrath's doing on the yellow bike, on the blue bike. And then gotta go down to KTM to pick up one of the little electric 50s and return a bike that I borrowed for Pablo at the Worlds. And then it's to State Fair MX for the mini major. Look good on blue.
Thanks. Thank you. I like the blue.
How much more comfortable are you now from the first day I saw you?
I would say I've never been this comfortable on a motorcycle.
Really?
It's, even this week, Tuesday, was a little bit of a rough day, just still learning, but today it's like kind of back to the basics in a sense of just riding the motorcycle and trying to break bad habits. And so with today, it's like I'm still learning every time I'm out on the track. That was kind of like, wow, I can't believe how the bike was working even just during that section.
Funky two corners kind of in the back of the track?
Yeah.
The left and the right?
Yeah.
You went through the right so fast, you went out of my camera screen once.
How close were you?
I was pretty close, but still, you caught me off guard how fast you went through it.
Yeah, the track's a little slippery, so sometimes that's on accident, but it feels really good. I'm super happy on the bike.
Hey, Shane, did you know that your father-in-law is one of the premier CMC Motorsports 125 Junior racers of the 90s?
Really?
Yeah.
I bet he was on it.
That's my claim to fame, Dom. Oh, yeah, shoot.
124.
Man. That's right.
You know, how about his brother, Crazy Jerry? Uncle Jerry. You know Uncle Jerry?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah. Where is Uncle Jerry?
He's right there.
Listen, Jerry.
Yeah.
With a haircut?
I thought you were joking.
Are you kidding me?
That's him, bro.
Oh my God, dude.
I thought you were joking.
I got some for you.
What? So I can scare my dog?
Yeah.
send you a video of it later?
Yeah, you gotta do it. So
he's gonna freak out.
He's gonna freak out, huh?
Yeah,
my dog shit his pants. So when you're not man enough to have a husky, you have a pomsky.
Why do you have to go there?
Huh?
Why do you have to go there?
I'm just saying, you know? It's like a mini husky, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm small. Yeah, I'm small.
Is there any truth to the rumor you named your dog after your team rider?
No, his name was Ty when I bought him, but it's also very confusing. We found that out.
So you got a hand me down?
Does the other Ty like
peanut butter? Huh?
Does Masterful, that Ty like peanut butter as much as your Ty?
I'm not talking to you.
How long have you been back on the bike now?
Last Monday was the start, so a week and a half.
Really?
Yeah, we're trying to take a little bit of time off and kind of, it's a long like 11 months on the bike, so
Was the time off just super sweet and nice, or did you get itchy towards the end?
I got, bike-wise, yeah, I got a little bit itchy, but I knew that was good and I wanted to like make it even worse of a feel to get back on the bike, so. We only had like 5 days off from training after Motocross of Nations. We just slowly started doing some bicycling and low cardio stuff to kind of regroup and, you know, ease into it a little bit. But now that's the first week on Supercross and it's good. I'm enjoying it. Once you get off Supercross for a while, it's kind of fun to get back into it. So.
Are you guys on 2020s now or are those still 19s?
That's a good question. I'm probably on a 2020.
Yeah.
I would think so. They didn't change how I sell the bike. So we've developed the engine a little bit more, but other than that, the same bike is a 19, so nothing different. So I feel we're probably on 2020s.
Yeah. How's the chemistry with your new teammate?
Good. He's a very cool guy. Yeah, he's very he comes to you and he talks to you, so that's cool. I'm a little bit shy, but quick relationship started between us, and he's fit in pretty good with the team so far. It's fun to ride with.
Nice. So, how do you feel today? Third day back on the bike.
It's tough. Supercross gets your heart rate going a little bit more than the outdoors does. So, being off it for a while, being a little rusty, definitely gets your heart rate going. I was pretty sucking some wind out there, to be honest. So, you got a while till we go racing. So,
hey, you're on a new bicycle now, huh?
Yeah, Specialized. Yeah.
The last time I saw you, what, was like 3 weeks ago, and you're on your old bike?
Yeah, Intense, and then we...
those photos are worth nothing now that I shot.
The photo shoot was Intense, and then we switched to Specialized the next week, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, cool bikes. We're still waiting on the road bike, so can't wait to get that thing out. My road bike's pretty old now. I've had it for like 3 years, so looking for an upgrade.
KTM to pick up one of the electric 50s. What's the official name of this thing?
SXE5.
SXE5?
Yes.
What's the 5 for? This is obviously the first one, it's not the 5th.
I think it's just to kind of distinguish us being like the 50cc size bike. Yeah.
E5, SXE5.
Yeah.
What do you think, TK? Would this have changed your career?
Never. Now you're like...
Got a dead man's kill switch like my 3-wheeler.
So you always have to have a buddy who can pull you out of a jam at the last second. And that's what this guy and his boss are, right? So today, this afternoon, David at KTM gave us a KTM E5 electric 50. And I'm gonna put my little buddy Deegan Sugamelli on it this weekend, just because he has the right number. Mm-hmm. All right. So thank you again. You're always welcome. Bailing me out.
No problem.
Nothing like a last minute request, right?
It's normal.
So Piston Bones Printing.com. What's the website?
Printing Inc. Piston Bones Printing Inc.
Inc. You know, there would be a banner on our site if the guy would ever design it. But thank you again.
You're
as
welcome.
Always.
You're welcome.